It's finale day. We got 4 challengers, 10 stages, 10 guns, 40 targets, and only one winner for $25,000 and the championship belt. It's all going down right now on the Airgunner Challenge.
So here's how the finale goes down. There are 10 different stages and 10 different guns. One at a time, each contestant will run the course through all 10 stages, and the fastest time wins. Each target left behind adds 30 seconds to their overall time. And throughout the course, there are bonus targets that subtract 30 seconds from their overall time. Stage 1. Each contestant with the Sig Sauer Virtus will shoot out of a moving Humvee at 6 black blast cap bottles. For each red bottle, a 30-second penalty will be added to their overall time. Then at stage 2, they will run and climb their way up a dirt pile to the Day State Delta Wolf. They only need one hit at a 100-yard grizzly gong. There's a bonus Firebird in the middle that, if hit, will subtract 30 seconds from their time. At stage 3, with the Air Force Texan, they have to aim through 2 wacky inflatable tube men and hit 2 Firebirds and 1 can of shaving cream. At stage 4, they'll army crawl through the dirt and mud to the Umarex Air Saber Elite X2, where they'll get 2 shots to hit the plate in the middle. But they have to hit the plate in the middle or get a 30-second penalty added to their time for each red plate they hit. Then, there's a bonus Firebird at the bottom. If hit, 30 seconds will be subtracted from their overall time. At stage 5, using the LCS SK-19, our contestants will shoot through the LCS wall at 3 different targets at 30 yards. Target 1 is a Firebird. Then they have to move the wall to shoot at target 2, which are 3 beach balls. Then again, move the wall to shoot at target 3, which is a red mason jar. At stage 6, they have to hit 2 cinder block Firebirds with the Benjamin Bulldog 457 swinging at 50 yards. Then run to another Benjamin 457 on a bog pod and shoot across the pond at a stick of dynamite on Sasquatch's boat. Also, there's a bonus target here, a green mason jar that, if hit, subtracts 30 seconds from their time. At stage 7, with the Seneca Dragon Claw, they have to shoot this bullseye target with the Air Venturi Air Bolt at 100 yards. Then it's on to the paddle battle with the FX Impact on stage 8. At stage 9, we play a little spot it with the Air Arms TX200. They have to spot and hit 3 targets in 3 different shooting positions. Standing, sitting, and off the bench. In stage 10, in the prone position with the Umarex Gauntlet 30, they have to knock down 3 paddles from Sasquatch's boat. Then finally, the shot that stops the time and completes the course is a 180-yard shot across the pond at a bell. Remember, every target they leave behind adds 30 seconds to their time, every bonus subtracts 30 seconds from their time, and the fastest time wins. Let's get to it.